Time to grab your weed and a pot of gold, cause it's time to go back to the hood.
Leprechauns, born of earth magic. They were protectors of the king's gold and punish anyone who would steal it. But after the king died, they were all whisked away back into the earth, except for one.
Anyone here?
I haven't smoked a good pipe in a long time.
I see peril coming.
You filthy mortals have tried to steal my riches. Hello, love.
It's a leprechaun and he's after us. He wants his gold back.
Come on!
Damn!
Who the fuck just took my shit?
You compromised all you believed in once you got the gold.
No more running.
I like her.
You're going back to hell tonight.
How tall are you, sweetie?
About 3'6".
3'6"?
I make up for it in other areas.
Oh, this is wonderful working, baby. Woo! Work it!
Hello?
Leprechaun Back to the Hood is a 2003 direct-to-video black comedy horror film written and directed by Stephen Iromoli? I don't know, however you say it. It's the sixth installment of the Leprechaun series and, as of now, the last entry to star Warwick Davis in the title role. The film has the villainous Leprechaun rampaging through a town looking for his gold, which was stolen by a group of urban youths who are using it to fulfill their wildest dreams. He will hunt and kill to retrieve his gold. Or you can say it's just basically the same thing as all the other Leprechaun movies. What you can really say is happening in this movie is just the Leprechaun smoking more weed just to get himself more high, just to make it through this dang movie. The original setting for the film was a tropical island in the middle of spring break, though executives at Lionsgate had director and writer Steven, whatever his last name is, change the location of the film to an urban environment like the previous entry in the series. Why the heck didn't they just go with that idea? Probably because it would be similar to Jack Frost 2, which came out around that time. But I mean, come on, it would be much better having the leprechaun in a tropical island rather than just staying in the same location in a city. I mean, come on, think about it. Wouldn't you want to see a leprechaun on a tropical island? How it would survive? I mean, sure, it would be over the top, but it would fit the tone of the film. I guess one good thing I have to say about this movie is that the opening animation sequence is actually really awesome.
Leprechauns. These guardians summoned from the earth to protect the gold from falling into the hands of evil men, of wicked men, the king's reign would come to an end, and the leprechauns would find their home again, back in Mother Nature's embrace, except for the myth of the one that did not go back.
It's weird because it doesn't fit the whole tone of the film, but it's still awesome. Another cool thing about this sequence is that the three animators who worked on it have also contributed to Futurama and Looney Tunes Back in Action, along with a plethora of other animation credits like DreamWorks and Nickelodeon. Now you want to talk about the ending? Well, strap yourself in, because let me tell you, it's even worse than the ending from the last film.
Ninjas?
What the fuck? Kill us, motherfucker!
Hello?
Who the fuck are you? Where's Watson?
Watson?
Uh-huh.
No, he's unavailable, sorry.
You better not run up no skank. What you look like?
What do I look like?
Uh-huh.
Well, I got red hair and nice smile.
That sounds good.
Yeah, and I'm a pretty sharp dresser.
Okay.
Yeah.
You work out? You got a good body?
Yeah. I think I got a good body. Yeah.
How tall are you, sweetie?
How tall am I?
Uh-huh.
Well, about 3'6".
3'6"?
Yeah, but I make up for it in other areas, if you know what I mean. Hello? Hello?
Again, they do the same thing just like what happened on the previous film. They don't kill him. So now there has to be another sequel, but thank God there wasn't. Because so far this was the last film in the original series until it had to be rebooted in 2014. Which we will sadly look at tomorrow. I know many people say it's actually better than the last film, but I'm sorry, this one's actually worse than the last film. I mean, sure, it's a lot more entertaining, and it plays more towards comedy than horror, but still, it's just a terrible film. I mean, sure, it might be fun when you're stoned or high on drugs, but I mean, come on. As a standalone film, so far, I have to say it's the worst of the whole series. I give it one leprechaun getting high. Almost there. Almost finished with these dang leprechaun movies.